Hello children, welcome to chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss our next topic, preparation of olides. Before this we have discussed the cleansing action, lyophobic, lyophilic colloid, formation of micelles. So for these topics you may watch my video on my channel Chemistry with Santosh. So our topic is preparation of colloids. There are number of methods for preparing colloids, but here we will discuss only three methods. By chemical methods, second is braiding arc method, and third is peptidization method. So we will discuss only three methods. What are the methods? First is chemical method. Second is braiding arc method. And third is peptidization. Okay, so here we are going to discuss chemical methods. In chemical methods, the colloids are being formed, are being prepared by double decomposition, by oxidation, by reduction, and they form the molecules, and these molecules together form the particles, and that is size of colloidal particles. So by chemical methods we can prepare. Means in chemical methods the colloid is being prepared by double decomposition, by oxidation, by reduction, by hydrolysis. During this process they form molecules, and these molecules together form the particles of colloidal size. So by this method we can prepare the colloid. Here braiding arc method. In braiding arc method, you may be knowing the arc method. Okay, in braiding arc method we will see what is braiding arc method. In braiding arc method we will see that the two metals are the metal which colloidal solution we are going to prepare will be taken as electrode, and that will be immersed in a dispersion medium. And when these electrodes are connected to the battery, due to sparking, the metal change into vapor. The metal melt and change into vapor, and that vapor condense and form the colloidal solution. And peptidization is the method. By this method, we prepare the colloidal solution by adding dispersion medium and a small amount of the electrolyte. So three methods we have discussed here: chemical methods, braiding arc methods, and peptidization. So one by one we will discuss it. So here my chemical methods: when AS2O3 react with H2S, it forms AS2S salt with water. Means here DDB is double decomposition. So by chemical reactions they have prepared by DD composition, means double decomposition. Here AS2O3 reacts with H2S and it forms AS2S. Next is here oxidation. SO2 react with H2S and it forms the salt. 3S plus 2S2. And here that is oxidation. Now is hydrolysis. Hydrolysis, FeCl3 plus 3H2O gives out FeOH whole thrice plus what we have seen. We have seen that when ferric chloride reacts with H2O, it forms ferric hydroxide and HCl. So this is ferric hydroxide salt we have prepared. And next is gold chloride AuCl3 plus HCHO formaldehyde plus 3H2O, and it forms the product that is AuSol plus 6HCl plus HCOOH. Okay, so here we have seen that by chemical methods we have prepared the colloidal salt. By chemical methods we have prepared the colloidal cell, and colloidal cells can be prepared by chemical methods by the DD, this double decomposition, by oxidation, by hydrolysis, by reduction. And these means molecules obtained by the after the reaction, they aggregate and form the particles of colloidal size. So they form the colloidal solution. So here we have discussed the chemical methods for preparation of colloidal salt. Second method for preparation of colloid is electrical arc method. Electrical arc method or reading arc method. Here, this method is used for the preparation of colloid for the platinum, gold and silver. We want to prepare this colloid, this colloid of these metals, we use electrical arc method. So what is electrical arc method? Just we will see. Electrical arc method is nothing else but it is a process in which the metal electrode rod is melted due to electric arc and condense and change into colloidal salt. So we have to see here, if simply we say metal electrodes due to arc change into vapor, and this vapor condense, and this condense form get mixed in dispersion medium and salt of the. So this is the process. Like this we can remember. So how we can prepare it? We can write it here. I can show you that how to do this. So for this we are taking what? We take one apparatus like this, and we fill dispersion medium in it. We fill dispersion medium in it. And next what we put? Next we immerse two electrodes of metal. And it is fully covered with ice cubes. Here this we have put ice cube. Okay. So what is the process? Like this, if we want to prepare the shawl of platinum, then we will take platinum electrode. If we want to prepare gold electrode, we will take. If silver, we will take silver electrode. So we see there that here the electric arc is struck between the metal. The electric arc is struck between the metal electrode immersed in dispersion medium. Immersed in dispersion medium. Due to a strip of electric arc, this metal electrode melts and change into vapor. Change into vapor. When these vapors rises up and they condense. Due to ice what we have put in there. And they change into liquid form. And they mix with dispersion medium. So we get what? Salt. We get salt. So this is the process for electric arc method and bending arc method. You have to remember it that electrodes of metal will be taken. Which metal solution colloidal salt we are going to prepare. So what we have discussed here, like that we can summarize. We take metal electrode, we have taken electrode metal, and due to strip of electric arc, this metal melts and change into vapor, and this vapor when condenses it change into liquid and get mixed with the dispersion medium and we get colloidal salt. Vapor condenses and it mixes with dispersion medium and salt is formed. So this method is specifically used for preparation of platinum, gold and silver. So you remember it. It is a special method for preparing the colloidal solution of platinum, gold and silver. Third method for preparation of colloid is peptidization. What is peptidization? So what is peptidization and what is process of peptidization? How we prepare the colloidal solution by the process of peptidization? So in peptidization, one thing you have to remember, we take precipitate. What? Precipitate, and that is being added to dispersion medium. Dispersion medium in presence of a small amount of electrolyte. And we get colloid solution. So what I told we take precipitate and that is being added or being saved with dispersion medium in presence of a small amount of electrolyte is called peptidization. Means if you write the definition of peptidization, the process of converting a precipitate into colloidal solution with shaking in dispersion medium in the presence of a small amount of electrolyte is called peptidization. So we can write definition. What on the basis of that, what is peptidization? The process of converting a precipitate into the process of converting precipitate into a colloidal solution into a colloidal solution by shaking it with dispersion medium in the presence of a small amount of electrolyte is called peptidization. The electrolyte used is called peptidizing agent. This method is used for preparation of colloidal salt. Colloidal salt by using freshly precipitate. In this method, the precipitate absorbs the electrolytes, one portion, either positive or negative portion of electrolyte, and precipitate becomes positively or negatively charged. Ultimately, that breaks into smaller molecule of colloidal size, and by that the precipitate changes into colloidal solution.